Hey guys, it's Sydney, and I am one of the James C. Davis interior designers. Today, we're going to talk about how to prepare a deck for a stain and how to apply the stain correctly. Before you begin staining your project, it's important to thoroughly sweep the deck to remove all leaves and debris. From there, apply a cleaner using a roller or a pump sprayer, and then work the surface using a stiff bristle brush to remove all residue, and be sure to rinse your deck thoroughly. We suggest allowing your surface to dry for up to 3 days. Once the deck is completely dry, you're ready to apply your stain. First, protect your exterior walls with painter's tape. Simply apply the painter's tape where the exterior wall meets the top of the deck. This will protect walls from stain. It's also a good idea to wet or cover any surrounding shrubs or plants to protect them from product splatters. Next, you should add a drop cloth to the area that will be stained last. This will be the surface where you'll lay your paint tray, stain cans, and all other materials. And from there, you'll stir the stain. You can do that right in the can using a paint stir stick. Then, pour the stain into the tray. You'll attach the pole to your paint roller and ensure a tight fit. If you're using a brush for a smaller area, just skip this step. Now, you're ready to stain. We suggest starting with any pickets or rails and then staining the flat surfaces of your deck. Dip the paint roller or paint brush into the tray and apply a solid coat of stain to the entire surface. Once the surface is complete, apply stain to the sides of the deck with a paint roller. If the paint roller doesn't cover inside spaces or between boards, use a 1-inch paintbrush. It would work just fine. You should allow 24 to 72 hours for the stain to dry before placing furniture on the deck. And that's it! If you have any questions about the right stain or materials for your deck project, just stop in and see us.